yourself back to when you first learned to drive, get the picture of it, remember way back when you used to signal to change lanes, okay? Both hands on the steering wheel, I'm focused, okay? I got the driver's ed teachers, they're with me. I got a pad, I want my license. Now fast forward to today. You ever been headed home from work or the supermarket or wherever? You pull into your driveway and it's like, whoa, how did I get here? It's like, man, who was driving? Because it's automatic. You've done it so many times. When's the last time you were eating and you missed your mouth with your spoon or fork? Hello? When's the last time you missed your mouth? You can remember last time? Well, that would be done. That would be done. Now recognize that this is not something that you always knew how to do. Hello? You didn't always know how to feed yourself. That's how the small child gets food in places. It's like you just turn your back for a second. You turn, how did you get food there? Hair, eyes, face. Because that's a new movement. Now, you've done it so many times. You've done it so often, and you've done it so often the correct way that you no longer have to be thinking about it as you do it. You can get as good at any other area of your life. You can get as good and as automatic in relationships, with money, with your health, and your spiritual or leadership. You can get as good. But the likelihood is that no one ever told you that you could, nor did they ever tell you how. If it was anything like my life experience growing up in Idabel, Oklahoma, a town of about 5,000 people, everybody kind of knew everybody, very black and white town, meaning the railroad tracks separated, divided the city from the east side to the west side. We were on the west side. And as far as I was concerned growing up, you had the haves and the have-nots. And for whatever reason, my family, we were all in the have-not line. And all I wanted to be able to do was change lines. Am I communicating this? I just wanted to be able to change lines. And I didn't realize it until I walked into the basic seminar. Though I always wanted that, I had always had that dream, I had lost the belief in it. I had started, there was a part of me for sure that doubted that that would ever be a part of my life experience. And so this guy is teaching the class. He's going on and on about this and this and the possibilities and this. Why would you think? And to be very honest with you, I shared with the class already this weekend, so I tell the guests. To be very honest with you, what was going on through my mind was, that's how it works for white people. Or that's how it works for other people. That is not how it works for people like me or where I'm from. Now, you don't have to be white or black to understand that. You may have had similar conversations. Some people get to, and other people don't. And so I wasn't bought in with this guy. I wasn't really tracking with him. And he mentioned this idea that we become what we think about. He said that to think is to create. He said everything is created twice. From the chair you're sitting in, the clothes you have on, this hotel we're in, these easel pads, those markers, it's all created twice. He said, where is it created first? And that made sense to me. Oh, it's first in the mind. It didn't just appear. It's created in the mind of the person that has the idea. He said, yeah, and then there is the physical manifestation of it. It's like, okay, that makes sense. And he went on to say, so if that's the case, then why wouldn't it be the same for other areas of your life? What if you found out that your predominant ways of thinking were driving the results that you were creating? And I was like, that would be pretty interesting to find out. And so I decided to tune in and listen. What did I have to lose at that point? And that's what I would say to you. If you trust the person who's invited you to be here, and you knew that it was 3 days of you spending time with you, just uncovering what your predominant ways of thinking are, and maybe see if there's a match between your predominant ways of thinking and the results that you have. Just to see. And if you do that and you find out that it is not the case for you, then there's a money-back guarantee on the course. Did you know that? There's a money-back guarantee. If you create no value in the past, you get your money back. So if my predominant ways of thinking and the results that I'm creating are matching up, that would be worth knowing, especially since most of my thinking, I have no idea that I'm doing it. Most of the predominant ways that I think, I've been thinking that way since I was 8 years old. Most of what I believe about the world, I've been believing it since I was 8 years old. So what if you found out that there was not someone there who was going to tell you what to do or how to live your life? You have a number of exercises, a number of experiences whereby you get to see your thinking in this area. How's the way you think in this area? What's the most predominant way of thinking that you have in this area? And then just see. Right? No expectation. Just see if whether or not those ways of thinking match the results that you're creating. The likelihood is you're going to find out a lot of ways of thinking that you didn't know that you do know, and that you didn't know that you don't even know. Communication, you're being what? Well, there is more to you than you know. But most people hang out at the conscious level of mind, reasoning, logic, mind. It's got to make sense to them right now, or they won't take action on it. These are the people that are like, well, I got it, you know, I'll believe it when I see it. You ever known conversations like this? I'll believe it when I see it. Or the people who say, well, okay, I understand you graduated from the course tonight. Now let me see how it works for you over the next 2 months, and then maybe I'll check it out. That is ridiculous. And not very supportive. Okay, all right. Well, let me see how it works for you, and then, right? So now your relationship has to be on trial. You know, the person you're in relationship with now, they're on trial for the next 2 months, proving to you that they got something out of the course. Okay? That's one way of doing it, I guess. But understand this. If your biggest goal or dream is one that you already know how to do, then you can never go any further than where you've already been. I said that kind of fast, I'll say it again. See, reason and logic mind says, I'm going to only set goals that I know how to do already. If I don't fully understand it, if I don't know how it's going to turn out, if there are any unknowns, then I'm not going to do it. And what I'm getting at or suggesting is that if your goals or dreams are set based on what you already know how to do, then you can never go any further than where you've already been. You've maxed out already. You've plateaued already. There is more to you than you know. So much more. There is an infinite intelligence that is locked up in every molecule of your being, with the answers to any problem, with the answers to any situation or challenge that you're faced with. But most people are convinced that that is not the case. And so throughout the course, then, what we're looking to have you do is to expand both personally and professionally and be more effective in those areas now. Okay? Keyword being now. Like when a small child wants something, when do they want it?
Now.
And if you're small, you know, it's the holiday season, you know, they got the toy of the year, they run into Toys R Us, and they're like, Mom, Dad, can I have this in May? I'm sorry, I lost my mind for a moment. I'm gonna go put it back. We'll wait till May, you know. Maybe as we're leaving, they'll have a brochure, and we can take that home and, you know, peruse the brochure and see if this is a wise decision, because I know I'm always choosing toys. And but if your child or grandchild responded like that, you'd be like, something's up. Okay? Because inherently, we want what we want when?
Now.